trying to steal my orange juice.
No, I'm not.
You're trying to steal this.
Yes, I'm trying to pay for it.
You're trying to steal my orange juice.
Says she shook the gun. I'm gonna put her in hell. Hey, it's moving away from her.
Yeah. Hey, yo, what's going on, man? Yo, man. Anything is anything, man. Just get that cream light, man. For real, man. You know what we striving for, man. We got family members. Hey yo, high potency top. Smoke a bag of black and feel a vibe. Born to be wise, be form on the rise. The corner mean five. Horns in disguise, throw on your slides. Young niggas racing, smokers is basing. You seen the eyes laying up, playing the cut. What? Stay in the truck. Something told me duck. Folded me up, my shoulders struck. Out of luck, fuck the potters up. Fell in a daze like a galata of snuff. Niggas tried to body me up. I'm in the lobby bleeding. Niggas in the renting office probably eating and sprinting and beefing. When they heard the shots fall of precinct and seen Barbara Niece's beast, a nigga shot Shalaw features and shot through his Elises. Bent the spider callers creatures. I'm gagging and flagging the cab down. Guess who in the Benz wagon? Dragging my sound down. Magging it was Del Greedy, the greedy. Conniving there, snake genie. Cop with a bikini who murdered Charles and Bernini. I'm feeling wheezy and I'm drained from the Chiba. Grieving ain't even looking decent. Seeing police, niggas reaching it.
That splash against my hollow bones.
In the crime scene, speeding, beeping, leaving behind cream. Not even peeping that I was leaking. Won't see the precinct, just got a recent case. Beating still, Jake's a creeping. Don't blow your spot. Stay the weekend, keep the rug appealing. Who's squealing? Few knew the dealings. Keep the steel concealed in, cause we got no time for feelings. Eyes on the building, corns are on the corners healing. $1 million block villains plotting on a killing. Feel like a superhero, talking like a true De Niro. They boost his ego, found them broke down, reduced to zero. Cops fill reports, hoping I reveal my source. Source.
That splash against my hollow bones. That rocks my soul.
Outside the check cashing, flashing, dipped in fashion. Five cherry face faggots try to cash in. They keep laughing, ghost, you get your face bashed in. Who give you these privileges, son? Why you maxing and we?
Let's splash against my hollow bones.
Feeding to take those, move slow. I'm hearing how you broke Ross' nose. And I heard you keep a banging hammer. Golden brass, diamonds, and rotaries that was stolen as you haven't reported. G, make very little noise. My shit hiccup, don't make this big stick up. Big up me and the boys. I thought for a second and chose rather than froze. Had the gem star in my hand, yo. What the fuck, yo? That's when I ripped Timothy. Snatched some dip, jump right in back of him. Had the mini axe to him. Faxed him, shots rang off. Bing, boggly dunk.
That splash against my hollow bones.
Do you feel worried or nervous going into stores? Taking in for Latasha Harlins, both that I talked to. Did you think so? Is that what people were saying? What were people saying to you?
If a black person killed a Chinese girl, they probably get that person life or something, or 10 years in jail. And they only gave that lady 5 years of probation and 40 hours of community service.
What is your name again, son?
Anna Spelly.
Spell it for me, both names, please.
E-N-N-I-S-B-E-L-E-Y.
And which school do you go to?
Western Avenue.
And what grade are you in?
6.
Okay. When's your project due for the BBC?
In April the 29th.
Okay. Significant day, isn't it? Thanks for your time. I appreciate your help.
All right. Ready to go. cost a pretty penny to get both of them together. Where's over there, where the hook is on the knees at?
I never seen him.
Okay, no. Tasha, here we are. We still
you finally
kid.
Came to see me.
Yeah, I guess you said, girl, y'all been fighting. I don't know about y'all, but I've been coming out here for a long time. I come out here.
See, I wasn't here when
you were buried, Latasha. No. Yeah.
I got here 2 weeks after.
They shined her flag.
Oh.
How nice.
Oh, how pretty. Hi, baby. Here we are. I'm gonna get a picture too. How lovely.
Oh, gonna get a birthday picture.
A birthday?
Mm-hmm. No, they just have the year.
Mm-hmm. I want to find my blood. Put some in there.
Flowers. Yeah, they put that down. That wasn't there before either.
Nope, come back
but
here.
When bring them, them kind of flowers.
Yeah, I ain't going to take anything out.
No, I'm not going to take anything out. Because we'll put this one on Christmas card.
That is so pretty.
That's like granite or marble or what?
Yeah. The cemetery donated the plaque.
Oh, that's lovely. We should write about
that. We
gotta
get Crystal one. We don't have a market for Crystal though.
But what we...
So we can find out.
Well, let's do a prayer, you guys.
Mm-hmm.
I have to let
it go. Let's go start with a prayer.
Mm-hmm.
That's
what I'm saying.
Give it your feelings.
Sorry, sorry.
Bye, baby. We love you. You got the direction?
Yeah. Chris don't have a marker on her grave, but we're gonna get one for her and her mama.
Weather from KFI. Mostly clear tonight. Some late night fog along the beaches. Overnight lows in the 40s. We'll have fog near the coast in the morning. Otherwise sunny and cooler with Santa Ana winds beginning in the afternoon. Highs Friday just mid to upper 60s. Right now 59 degrees in Fullerton, 57 in Thousand Oaks. It is 61 degrees here in Los Angeles. KFI does local news on the hour, on the half, and when it breaks at 7:07. I'm Ken Gallagher. KFI News.
Yeehaw!
KFI AM 640, more stimulating talk radio, Thursday night, January 28th. Barbara Whitesides with you until 9 o'clock. Thanks for tuning in. You don't want to go anywhere for the next 2 hours because this is a very unique show tonight, an opportunity you haven't been afforded before to hear the words of and ask questions of two women that have been very much in the news over the past couple of years, but you haven't had the opportunity to speak with him. Angela King, who's Rodney King's aunt, and Newz Harlins, who's Latasha Harlins' aunt, both with me tonight. Welcome both of you to KFI.
Thank you.
Thank you for being here tonight. Now, you have joined forces demanding justice for your family members. Explain that for me.
Let's see. How can I say this? Shortly after Latasha Harlins got shot, and I saw that video on the TV.
This is Angela King speaking.
I was really hurt. You know, a young girl at that age, and especially shot in the back of the head. And then I've been following her.
It's the biggest appliance sale of the year. The Sears National Home Appliance Sale. But it's going to be over. It's the appliance sale of the year. But it's going to be over on Saturday. So if you want to save money, there's only one place you've got to go now. Sears Brand Central. Prices may vary in Alaska, Hawaii, and Puerto Rico.
You can count on me. Sears Robot Company.
Dr. Laura Schlesinger on...
Dating younger men. No useful, stimulating conversation afterwards, but what the heck.
On Monday through Friday at noon on KFI AM 640. More stimulating talk radio.
KFI AM 640. More stimulating talk radio. Thursday night, Barbara Whitesides with you till 9. Southern California weather from KFI. Clear tonight, overnight lows in the 40s, and then some fog in the morning, otherwise sunny and cooler. Friday's highs in the mid to upper 60s, 54 now in downtown Los Angeles. And here at KFI, I've got Rodney King's aunt, Angela King, and Latasha Harlins' aunt, Denise, in studio with me. And we're going to get, Angela, I want to get to some questions with you. But before we do that, Denise, you wanted to read something that Latasha had written 2 weeks before she was shot.
And it'll also show you the frame of mind that she was in as well. And Latasha Shill reads that, "I am very reliable and trustworthy, honest. I like that I'm confident about myself. I have a lot of talent, and I know that whatever I set my mind on something, I am going to accomplish it. I show people that I care by giving what I have to people who actually need it. I also show that I care by showing respect to all adults and ones my age and younger. I know I care. What I want most in life is to fulfill my goals as being an attorney and also to graduate from high school with an almost perfect GPA and go to college. The most important thing to me is that my family is always protected by a shield so they won't be harmed by dangerous, ruthless, uncaring people. If I had one wish, it would be to get my mother back to me. Three descriptive words my friends would probably give me are caring, sharing, and very polite to others. Latasha Harlins, February the 6th, 1991.
Okay, we've got a couple of calls we want to get to, Denise, because people want to ask you something. You want to put your headphones on here. Here is Tracy in Diamond Bar. Hi, Tracy. Welcome to KFI.
Hi, Barbara.
Hi.
Hi, Ms. Harlins. How you doing?
I'm fine. Thank you. And yourself?
I want to start off by saying your niece, that was a tragic death of her. But there are several things I think we need to look at. First of all, the responsibility of raising children today. And I think she's a product of the society and the area that she was brought up in. And the amount of denial that goes on to people that things like this happen to is incredible. First of all, the video doesn't lie. And, I mean, where was the orange juice when this whole thing happened? Was it in her bag or was it in her hand?
The orange juice was, as she walked to the counter, she puts the orange juice in her backpack, which was visual at all times as she approached the counter with $2 in her hand.
Well, see, that's one thing that you cannot see in the video. And that's really...
No, you can't see her leaving the refrigerator section. You can see her going up to the counter. You also can see the orange juice, the backpack on her back with the orange juice revealed. You can see that.
Okay, thanks, Tracy. Here is Kathy in Buena Park. Hi, Kathy.
Hi.
Welcome to KFI.
Thank you. The reason I'm calling is my father was killed in a liquor store robbery a couple of years ago when I was a child. And I get really upset because what Ms. Harlins, I think, has done, and a lot of the African community has done, is blame what happened by this one lady tarnished the whole Korean community. And I think you saw a lot of that effect throughout the riots, how all the liquor stores were mostly Korean-owned, or how a lot of Korean businesses were burned. And how, I mean, right after Miss Harlins was shot, her aunt was, her niece was shot, it was all over the Black Crusade, Brotherhood Crusade, were all out there revenging Koreans, you know, saying it's Koreans' fault. And I'm so sick and tired of hearing that, you know, we're rude to African-Americans, or we're rude to this. Well, you know, a lot of it had to do with culture. I mean, culturally, you know, we were brought up to respect people, not look at them straight in the eye, you know, put your hands down, you know, when you're serving people. And because we're being blamed.
Are you Korean?
Yes, I am.
Oh, I understand where you're coming from. But you need to know, caller, that I don't blame the entire Korean community for the death of Latasha. One person only killed Latasha, which was Soon Ja Do. Now, where the Korean community come in for a play, in my eyes, is that when they raised up over $1 million for Do's legal defense fund in protecting a murderer that heinously killed a child, then that's where I come in at. And that's where you saw many African-American people in our community stood up and said, enough is enough. Now, if you're talking about equal justice, I mean, you wouldn't see us raising $1 million for an African-American person that killed any child, not alone Black, Korean, white, or whatever color you want to say.
Right.
We don't do things like that.
Exactly. But I like to know. I mean, I don't know all the details, so I can't, you know, I don't want to defend Miss O or your niece. You know, I don't know the full details. But, you know, why is it that when our, I mean, a lot of Asian-Americans, especially Koreans, do own liquor stores and, you know, cleaners and all these businesses, small-type businesses, and there are—I mean, there are hundreds that have been killed, and my father has been one of them.
Well,
and I mean, why is it that every time, you know, there have been children killed that we don't go out as a community, and we—I mean, our community, I say we don't have a strong voice, and I think that is one of
you only have a strong voice if you're doing what you're doing right now. The Korean community is not being blamed. The liquor stores in our community, yes, there are too many in our community that really hurt our people. My position is that Korean people were forewarned before all of these things transpired to come and to join forces with us in fighting for justice, just like they are right now because of other moves we are getting ready to galvanize around in reference to what Carlin's done. You need to point the finger at the judiciary, the people that's responsible.
You bring up a good point here, Denise, because at one time you tried to get together enough signatures, a petition drive to have Judge Carlin removed from the bench. And at that time, she was up for re-election, yet she was re-elected. How do you explain that? I mean, the people re-elected the woman.
Well, actually, it wasn't the people that re-elected her. It was judges and attorneys that buy Carlin's up with all kind of monies, being in the power play up under the circumstances. The recall movement that was going on did take away potential voters from getting involved in the voting, whereas there was not enough strong campaign out to bring the people aware of what was going on. There were over 40 to 80,000 people that went out and vote that did not vote in favor to or for Carlin.
Now at over 70 Aaron Brothers locations. Don't miss it. The KFI Newsroom.
KFI AM 640, more stimulating talk radio. Thursday night, Barbara Whitesides with you until 9, then it's Marilyn Kagan to midnight, the best of KFI from midnight to 5 a.m. With me in studio tonight, Angela King, Rodney King's aunt, Andy's Harlins, Latasha Harlins' aunt. And we're talking about a myriad of things, and your phone call's coming up as well. Angela, I wanted to get with you now, because there's an awful lot, a lot of ground to cover here tonight. What happens if the four officers that go on trial next month are acquitted again?
I would really hate to comment on that.
Would you be shocked?
One,
do you expect
example,
that?
I don't expect anything good out of it if they are acquitted. And first of all, I doubt it, seriously.
You doubt that they will be acquitted?
They will be acquitted this time.
What do you think is going to be different this time?
Well, let's hope the evidence. Let's see.
Do you think
that
things such as...
how can I say this? This what do you call this here? The system
mm-hmm.
of of men being treated equal. You know, in the Justice Department. See, that brings us to, like, they're trying to tie in the LA-4 as the same as the four officers that beat Rodney.
Do you see a connection?
I don't see no connection at all.
Why not?
Because Rodney was pulled over by the law enforcement, okay, and should have been taken straight to jail.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, you know, instead of out there with metal batons, flashlights, and electrical currents going through his body like some dog. Reggie Denny, at that particular time, I won't reveal all this information, but I understand that these guys were angry about the verdict for Rodney, and he happened to pull up in this big old truck and was yelling racial slurs and asking them to get out of the way. And the police officers were there at the time all this was being yelled out. And when the police were called back, this is when, you know, the beating of him started.
Do you think the LA-4 will be acquitted? This is just your
That's
opinion,
hard
your
for me.
Thoughts.
No, I don't think they'll be acquitted because they're talking about giving those young guys, what, 25 years.
I mean, the two of you have got a pulse beat of what is happening involved in both of these cases.
Mm-hmm.
If these four kids are sent to jail, how do you think the reaction is going to be within the community? And I can't think of anybody that I could ask that would have more of a feeling of how the community feels than the two of you.
You know what? I really think that the people in the courts and the police and the political officials should be the ones to answer that question, because as where I come from and from history, it's known that the judiciary system is not equal amongst the color lines. There's no equal justice. I really fear that these little young brothers that's going through these courts right now, and the way that they're being treated, like they're murderers and all, I mean, worst type murders that you can ever see, I mean, quote unquote, that they are facing a life sentence, to whereas when I turn around and see what the cops did, who are in the heart of our communities, government officials, there to serve and to protect the people, and yet using the type of forces that they're using to contain the people and to mistreat people in our community.
Like, you talk about a racial issue there, and
it is a racial issue because they make it. They make it a racial issue, not us. They make it.
But explain this to me. Why were the passengers in Rodney King's car left alone? If it were truly racial, why weren't they
beaten? They weren't left alone. They were beaten. Byron Ellis was beaten.
Let me explain this. They weren't left alone. Freddie Hams, which is the guy that's dead now, he was beaten up in the back of his head. He required, I believe it was 21 stitches, and he was on crutches even when he died. Brian Allen.
I've never heard about any of this before.
Montel Williams revealed a videotape of Byron Allen getting beat.
I saw Freddie the next day. And as a matter of fact, we were coming from the hospital trying to stitches. He was unable to walk on one leg. Brian Allen has bruises in his chest and in his back where he was also kicked and poked with the batons. The only reason that you haven't heard as much about them is because they were so busy over here with this other animal to them. You know, I would have done the same thing. I would have reacted.
Okay, let's go back to the phone lines. Here's Herb in Los Angeles. Hi, Herb.
Hi, can you hear me? The young lady said before I was hard to hear.
Yeah, you're fine.
Oh, fine. Okay, great. Basically, what I was going to say is with 25% of young black males in the prison system, it's no wonder people are very, very cautious, and I am too, when I see more than one black male together, especially when they look like they may be gang members. But anyway, I know you're going to say that's racist, so let me say something else. There were, with about a week before the riots, there were by black gang members. One was a black gang member ran into a gentleman who was holding a baby in his arms. He dropped the baby and the baby died. I didn't hear a word from the black community about that. What I really believe, lady, is you just hate whites, so you could care less about black
people. Who are you talking to?
I'm talking to any of the two ladies that are there.
Listen.
All you care about is if a white kills one black, you scream like hell. Blacks can kill hundreds of thousands of blacks, and you don't say a
listen,
damn
sir,
word.
That's not true because.
Needs to sit down.
Is he still
relax.
On the line?
Yeah, he's still on the line.
Okay, that's not true because what about these policemen that beat up? Was it a white policeman? In a bank.
Are you talking to me?
I don't know which case you're referring to.
Yeah, I have something to say to you. You are absolutely wrong. I don't have anything to say to you because I think you have a problem.
My problem. People like you can care less about black people. All you care about is if a white kills a black, you scream like anything. If blacks murder black by the hundreds of thousands,
Herb, I think you're way in left field right here. I mean, we as black people do have our own problems within our own communities, in which there is a lot of people that I know of. I wish you need come down in our community and deal with some of the people that have to deal with the problems. We're trying to deal with our problems with our youth. You understand what I'm saying? But that doesn't make it equifiably justifiable to allow someone to come in and to mistreat people because they are of a lesser kind, the way that you put those type of label. You're the ones that put
because
that kind
of
label
color.
On them. Because of their colors. You're the one that put that label on them, not me.
Why would you say a lesser kind? That was a strange expression.
Because people, I am so tired of people mistreating other people. If, for instance, dude quoted that had Latasha come from a better life, Latasha would not be dead. What do that mean? That's a lesser kind. And whereas Du also stated if given the opportunity to kill again, she would. And then Judge Carlins turns around and say that this woman will not kill again and releases this woman on 5 years probation. They just explained to me how devalued the black life is.
Okay, we're going to continue. Don't go away. I'm Jennifer Ballman.
What are the odds your team is tomorrow on AM 640 KFI?
KFI AM 640, more stimulating talk radio. Thursday night, Barbara Whiteside's with you until 9 o'clock. Thanks for tuning in. Rodney King's aunt Angela is with us. Latasha Harlins' aunt Denise, also my guest tonight. 7:50 right now. Let's go back to the phone lines. Here is Mark in Santa Monica. Hi, Mark. Welcome to KFI.
Hi. First, I'd like to express my sympathy with Denise and her niece's family. I watched both videos on TV and was appalled by what I saw and the justice that was handed out. Given the current outrage with the justice and justice system, I want to know how people can possibly have a different definition of justice for the youth involved in the Reginald Denny beating. How can people suggest that we repeat injustice and let them go free as their mothers and others in the African American community suggest? I mean, I saw three videos. Just because two incidents resulted in gross injustices, does this mean a third must follow suit?
No, you're right. Two wrongs don't make a right. I'm going to let Angela answer that one.
No, go on.
Well, the way that I see it, with Reginald Denny, it's not so much because I sympathize with what happened with Reginald Denny as well as Rodney King, and I really feel that if they're going to punish these young brothers for committing this alleged assault on Reginald Denny, then they should also as well prosecute the cops, and even worse, because they are city governed by the city, or they are to serve and to protect the people.
But the justice system doesn't work that way,
Denise. It doesn't work that way, but then that's why we have the problem, the type of problems that we have out here today.
So do we let them go?
Only you let them go. I mean, if you let the cops go, yes, you let those little young brothers go, because it's not going to be equal justice. I don't think those little young brothers should serve any kind of time in prison for the same thing. I mean, we need equal justice here. Now, I mean, whatever they get charged with in the courts, if they are going to get punished, then you give them the type of punishment that you would give someone of another color or standard or whatever the case may be. You give them what they deserve, not to overcharge them because of the judiciary, who is responsible for this whole entire matter. Okay. Blame these young brothers for that. You don't do that.
Thanks, Mark. Here is Ben in San Francisco. Hi, Ben.
Yeah, I believe that the four LA four guys should get off, and I think that even if they are guilty, they should get off, because I believe that the whole system is entirely corrupt.
It is.
There is an audio portion of the George Halliday tape, and you can hear
the racial slurs.
Rodney King a nigger. You can
sure.
hear You can hear him giving Rodney King orders, mm-hmm. and the orders are obeyed instantly. This is played on the Montel Williams show, but it's been covered up by the media. If you look at the Rodney King video, you can see Brian Allen being beat in the first part of the video. If you look in the right part of your screen, right behind the hundy, mm-hmm. you can see an officer kicking Brian Allen. He's on the ground.
Yeah.
Terry White says he doesn't see that. Terry White
wow.
is lying. Terry White also hid the fact that racist epithets were used repeatedly, not only during the beating, but in the hospital. The
you think all this was withheld in the courtroom, Ben?
It was.
You're not aware of it. You just said a few minutes ago you didn't think Brian Allen was beat. Both Brian Allen, Rodney King, and the third passenger
Freddie Helms.
Why did the news media cover that up? I think people should be very angry about the
discourse. Why do you think the news media necessarily covered that up, Ben? Certainly, you know, when it comes to either one of these cases, neither one of us were sitting on that jury. We see bits and pieces, and everybody has an opinion, but to sit on the jury, I mean, if you believe in the criminal court system, I mean, you don't know everything, supposedly, until you get in the courtroom.
Okay, can I say one thing as far as that jury is concerned?
What took place wasn't even revealed in the courtroom, I believe, because I believe the prosecution didn't want it to be.
Well, now you just said the media was covering it up. Now you say they are. What do you say to
that? He's absolutely right, because several things that weren't brought out in the courtroom, and I had asked about them, and they said no, they didn't want to start no riot here. Okay. Several things. And as far as that jury that was sitting up
who
there,
told you that? Who said they didn't want to see any riot?
I'm not going to say the names.
But,
I mean,
are you talking about?
I'm talking about an official, you know, someone there in the courtroom that had some say.
And you said, why isn't this being brought out? And they said they don't want to see a riot.
Correct. They said, Angela, you don't want to see no riot here, do you?
Okay, we're going to continue.
And the jury, well.
We got to take a break. We're going to be right back.
By AM 640.
Oh, you think the Denny Beater should be set free?
640 more stimulating talk radio. Thursday night, Barbara Whitesides with
okay.
you until 9 o'clock.
So they should be in jail.
And
what about
King
the police?
And Denise Harlins. Latasha and Rodney's aunts are with me.
So that's all you want to say?
Black males, actually, the overall community itself. And if we do anything out of
KFI.
The ordinary, we may
okay,
get
what's your comment?
Punished or taken downtown. So they're on alert, and they are more... The communication between us and the LAPD.
Gene, go ahead, because we're up against the clock a lot here.
Okay,
so
and,
you think the news media hasn't shown this?
The re-election of Judge Carlin, 60% of the Valley re-elected Judge.
Thanks. First of all, a lot of people don't realize that Rodney King was in prison for beating a Korean shopkeeper with a tire iron. And this is the guy that we're treating as a latter-day as Aristotle.
No, you're misinterpreting that. It wasn't no tire
coming
iron. It was a bread basket.
Sensationalizes everything and gives everybody their opinion.
They did, I think they should have been disciplined. I don't think there's any question of...
Okay, thanks, Stephen. I want to ask you real quick, Angela, before we go to the news.
How old are you?
Because certainly what Steve...
Are you a first-time caller?
What has come up... Since
okay, great.
Time.
Hold on. When Barbara says your name and where you're calling from, jump in, Jackie.
With your
all right, hold on.
He's been stopped three times since the original beating. Now there's this deadbeat dad thing out in San Bernardino.
That they're following him. They have Rodney.
KFI.
Mark, you know, and
but every time he was stopped,
what do you want to say?
Go. They didn't press any charges on those.
They
three
had no evidence. See, this is what I'm talking about. They pulled
okay,
him
and why?
Let everyone know he's still in you know connections with the police, or he's still here. You know, this is just for the people to know. Well, Rodney's nothing. You know, Rodney's nobody, an ex-con, and out here he's a troublemaker.
I'm the screener, ma'am.
But this is not true. This is something they tried to do, just like
you don't think it's
now.
Important to let
they
people
want,
see what people are thinking.
For something that's not there. Okay, I know.
Well, we have
I'm
two people
here.
Tomorrow. Would you say, Rodney, stay on the straight and narrow? You
of
know,
course.
Get your act together.
I tell him this every day.
You tell him that
I
every
tell
day.
Him
you talk to him every day.
Every day.
And you say, Rodney, come
I
on,
tell
don't
him, no, you know,
keep your nose
watch
clean.
What he's doing.
Stop doing that stuff.
But he knows this, so why should I tell him? He knows this. But you know, it's annoying to every time you turn around a corner because you're Rodney King, and for what you've been captured, you were on video and made these cops look like fools out here, or you know, caught him in wrongdoings. Then quite naturally, they're going to hunt you down and try to do something. But what I'm saying, I want to finish. Here's a man who was supposed to have been off of parole the middle of last year. Okay, now they prolonged that till December the 22nd. I mean 7th, excuse me. And now here he's still on parole. See, this is, they want him to do something so they can just send him back to jail and then this will all be under the covers. But I don't believe, not only for Rodney, for a lot of other black men or white or Hispanics that's been out there being beat to hell. This is what I'm speaking for. I'm not speaking of no racial motivation.
Okay, we're going to continue with Angela and Denise when we come back from the news. Don't touch that dial. 803 at KFI Los Angeles, more stimulating talk radio.
We don't hate any race of people. We dislike Soon Jai Do for taking our cherished child's life in the prime of her life, a 15-year-old child. And we're only asking that justice be served. Justice must prevail. Then maybe one day, after she's paid her due to society, then we can find the capacity in our heart to forgive her. But not until that time. And we feel the most healing thing that can occur if the Korean community cooperates with us in acquiring this building, that we can work hand in hand from now on at the Latasha Harlins Youth Center, providing jobs, job training, a cultural exchange, and a place of harmony. I think this will create racial harmony. It'll be something for the rebuilt LA people to do, to show something tangible almost 1 year later from April 29th. If they help us get this building and establish the Latasha Harlins Foundation and Youth Center, that'll be something for us to show the world that it's a beginning.
What's the primary roadblock right now in acquiring that building?
$300,000.
Is that what they want?
Yes, sir.
Have you started raising funds with that in mind, or?
Well, we haven't started a fundraising campaign. We're even negotiating with the Korean bank this coming week that holds the title. And we're also talking to philanthropists and corporate America.
So the committee has started negotiating with the
Korean
bank.
Yeah, but we haven't done a benefit or a building fundraiser at this point. We're hoping we don't have to. We probably will, because if we acquire the building, then we got to get money to do something inside of it, you know, to refurbish it and establish whatever type of program that we're intend to do it.
Do you have a phone number right here, Jen?
There you go, 213-299-9907.
Gina, G-I-N-A.
Uh-huh, last name Ray, R-A-E. Good afternoon.
Just give me your name again.
The little girls that were here?
Her little sister?
The smallest one?
That's her sister. That's Latasha's little sister.
You guys are members of the community there?
Those are concerned citizens of the community.
Okay. Your name?
My name is Gina, G-I-N-A, last name Ray, R-A-E.
And you are good for family?
I am the spokesperson for the family. I do the public relations, the media, etc. And I am known in the community as Queen Malka, M-A-L-K-A-H. I don't let the press use that name because they always screw it up. And it's too royal, too African, and too real for them to screw it up. So I don't let them have it, but I'll let you have it.
Who will use
somebody? Y'all want to hold this ass. You know,
she needs to be shot.
That's what she did.
Please, somebody listen to me. Time to the side of the sidewalk.
I didn't hear you. Well, what does it say? Hold it up. Let me see. I'll read it. Justice for Latasha. A bullet in the back of the head. 5 years probation, 400 hours of community service, and a $500 fine. Judge Carlin is an accessory to a child killer. She let a child killer go free. We must have justice for Latasha. What's this one saying? Never forget the injustice. Judge Carlin rendered in the decision. Say yours.
Judge Carlin.
Accessory to murder.
Accessory to murder. Third month, 1691.
The second anniversary of the slaying, the assassination of Latasha Harlins. We're here in conjunction with her anniversary of the judge that set her killer free.
April 29th is on your conscience, Judge Carlin! Carlin must go!
April the 4th, Judge Carlin must go!
Where will there be justice for Latasha?
April the 4th, Judge Carlin must go!
She's looking out for one of them little peepholes up there with all her bodyguards.
April the 4th, Judge
Carlin must go! Carlin must go! Carlin must go!
Carlin must go!
Carlin must go!
Carlin must go!
Carlin must go!
Carlin must go! Child, ever are free! Judge Carlin must go!
When will there be justice for Latasha?
Judge Carlin must go! Carlin's ruling over young children's lives after setting the murder of free! Judge Carlin must go! The remedy recall, April 4th!
Just take break.
Close the doors now.
Oh, I still need one to sit the picture on. I'm gonna put it a piece of newspaper down on another one. On the left, right where those green garbage cans are. I think it's on the right side. Okay, close the doors. You said you need the key to lift the window up.
Do you need a jacket?
Yeah.
Oh, what's the use using the camera? The focus ain't right.
You got a light on yours?
Your lens on. Both of you can wrap that around you.
Here, Mama.
Yes. My focus ain't right. Oh, now it's getting right.
Let me get these. Now, let me let this window out. And we ready to go.
Oh, gosh. Okay, come on. Give it to your own. Don't forget me.
I wonder if she at home.
Never know. Anticipated I come at home.
Are you cold?
No, it's nice out here. Shh. Oh, it's cold.
Chicago's cold. I got my 15 below,
I'll be there.
Why do they have pretty houses? Well,
this is
part of what we fight.
Plain and simple, they got pretty money.
Is this it right here?
That's the next one in.
Blue out. That's 149.
What?
I think. Oh, it's up there a little bit. You got the right one, baby.
This is a sign.
We'll get the station when we get ready to leave. But this is silent. This is a prayer. Peaceful. Silent prayer vigil. We'll get the station when we get ready to leave. That's right. Just like when we were at the graveyard today. Remember, we have the same thoughts we did at Paradise Cemetery. And remain very quiet.
Move in next time. We're safe.
They want your head.
fever, why would you want to look outside?
I know. Unless you have a teacher or something.
Why would you live on the most hardest street to find a mission home?
Well, we find it. Whatever they do, we still find it. Whatever the dudes do, they know they can depend on us this day to be standing on it until they move back to Korea. And if I can find my way, we might go there one day. That's the oops.
We made a wrong turn, didn't we?
We landed in Seoul, Korea. Guess who's here? We're back. We're not supposed to laugh, but this is very serious.
Sometimes I laugh.